Hello, good afternoon. Well, this is Ainhoa Manero from Stern Avogados, and I'm here with Juan Carlos.
Hello.
Hi, Juan Carlos, how are you?
Fine, thanks. And you, how are you?
Fine, thank you. Ready to answer all the questions. That this is becoming now something usual to come here.
My weekly routine for the live stream, yes.
Exactly. Exactly. We will see all the questions. We will also see things that maybe we are seeing with the procedures, and we can explain to them. Like, I would like to make an emphasis that we were talking about all those who can apply for Larga Duración Unión Europea. Is our recommendation to apply now if you can, if you have a stable economy, because you have now an employment. It is a good opportunity because we really don't know what is going to happen in the future, if there is going to be a bigger recession, and maybe you will like to go to Europe, to France, Germany, whatever, because there are better jobs there. So don't lose the opportunity to apply for the Larga Duración Unión Europea if you can, because remember that the student time counts in 50% and then the residency time as it is. So if they ask 5 years for Larga Duración, but you've been 3 as a student, those 3 becomes 1.5 years. So with 3.5 years of residency, you already can apply for Larga Duración Unión Europea. And that way you will be able, with a very little and easy procedure in the European country that you want to go, will allow you to go there and work. So it is a very, very good option. And it was something that we were saying to tell them in the next life, because it's something that that is important to look for the future. Because if we have the Larga Duración Unión Europea and our jobs are okay here, we can stay here perfectly, but it gives us more chances, that is, to go to Europe to work, right, Juan Carlos?
Yes, I agree totally. Well, I mean, the situation right now, it has a lot of issues. We don't know what's going to happen. Maybe we will have an economical crisis like 2008, 2009. A lot of people that were here in Spain, even immigrants, they had to go to other countries, like Germany, like Norway, like France.
Yeah.
And if you have to apply there for a new permit, it's going to be really hard. However, if you have a long-term permit for the UA, you're going to be able to exchange your current permit for a new permit there without having to reapply for everything again. So yes, we recommend you to do that. Now that you have a job, now that you have income, you are able to get this card. And then if the situation get worse in Spain, or even if it doesn't get worse, but you have some opportunities in other countries, you can get that opportunity without having to resign to your current permit, or without having to reapply for everything there. That is going to be very hard. So yes, just take the advantage right now and go for it.
Also, for those of you who don't have a job right now, I had a consultation this week from someone who was really worried, because she was working regularly all these 2 years, and just now, because of the COVID and everything, she lost the job and she was worried about the renewal. Remember, even if you don't have a job right now, but if you have been working for 9 months every year, you are able to renew and it shouldn't be any problem, okay? So don't worry. If you have these kind of questions, we are here to answer, but just know that even with 9 months and without a contract, you can renew, okay? Because this is something I think important, because there are people that are in ERTE, so it's like you are working, don't worry, but there are people that they just lost their job because they didn't renew their contract or whatever. So there are several ways to renew, even with 6 months and having a contract at the same of the at the time of the renewal, or even just with 3 months doing special reports. It's not easy to renew with 3 months, but it's possible. At least it's possible, and we have to try it. Of course, we have to try it. But well, let's see what really are the questions. These are things that I wanted to share with all of you. But Maria, let us know questions. Okay, Graciela, Paulina says, hello, I know I'm Juan Carlos. If I already passed the positive silence of the búsqueda de empleo, what shall I do if there is no letter from administration to process the fingerprints and get the car? Well, Graciela, nothing. The thing is, now anyone can do fingerprints, so don't worry, because with the COVID, no one is going to be able to do fingerprints now or even in a month, because it's going to be a lot of people needing an appointment. But really what you need to know is that when we have a positive silence, so when after 30 days or 20, because búsqueda de empleo is after 20 days, we have positive silence and it should have been approved, we need to know that we have the approval. Really, we don't have the letter, but we have the approval, and you need to know that already your residency towards larga duración, towards nationality, is already counting. At any time that you have an offer, you also will be able to change to practicas, for example, even if you don't have the resolution saying that is granted, okay? So don't stop doing whatever you need to do. If you get practicas, do the practicas, okay? Because you are applying for practicas to the immigration office, which is the same one that is behind issuing the resolution. So don't worry, you can do it. Fingerprints, you can't, but anyone can't, and it's not, it's, your rights are not in hold because you haven't done the fingerprints, okay? So congratulations.
Yes. Also, I think, Graciela, that we should recommend you to request the silence, because sometimes they forget. So a good thing to do in order to get this resolution faster is to start to get to give them letters every time and then saying, hey, my resolution is already on silence. I need my resolution. So you remind them that you need that resolution and ask them for the silence, stating that, of course, this letter must be done by a lawyer, or you must get it there, that you need your resolution, so they
well,
don't forget about you.
It's true. When there is positive silence, it is good that you ask for that positive silence, even if they are not issuing it, because we know they are behind. Write a letter, or with your lawyer, of course, asking for that positive silence, so there is no problem at all. Okay? Okay. Juan Carlos, maybe you want to read, because we are going to be reading all the others that they have also sent us on the week. Do you have it?
Yes, I have it. I have the first one. This is from Ryan Cole, and he's asking, that's the question actually, if I modify from a student visa to freelance so that I can work for companies that already exist, can I still start a company on a later date with that modification, or will I have to apply again?
So,
he's asking if he's a freelancer, he gets the freelance visa, will he need to reapply if he wants to set up a company?
No. So, the cuenta propia allows you to both things, to be a freelance and give your services, and of course, at any time, you can create the company and have the company, okay? So, really, it's even better if you do it, because they really prefer it. They see it more serious business as a company, so it's not mandatory, but at any time in the year, you can create the company, and after, when you have to renew it, you have to show everything that the first month you did as a normal autónomo, as a normal freelancer, and you did the invoices as a normal freelancer, and that after whatever month, you continue with the company and you show everything for the renewal and it's going to be perfect. Juan Carlos, something else?
Yes, just to add up that even if you don't have a freelance permit, you're able to set up a company and be a shareholder of the company, but you cannot work in the company, okay? So anyone can set up a company. Even the tourist can set up a company. Even if you're not a tourist, if you are living outside Spain, if you want to set up a company in Spain, you're able to do it. You can be the shareholder, the machine holder, and the only thing is that you're not going to be able to be at the administrator of the company, but you may choose a person that has a permit in Spain to be the administrator of the company, but you can hold all the actions of the company.
Exactly. So for you to understand, we create companies for tourists that they are not going to settle, or even for freelancer applications and for entrepreneur applications, because really immigration prefer it. So if you really, for all those of you that are planning and they want to have a company, you are able to have a company even without, as Juan Carlos said, without the permit. And it's going to help you to get the permit. So thank you for that clarification, Juan Carlos. Maria, no. Some other questions. Okay. Moratatim says, hi there. I want to ask where becoming a freelancer will allow me to work in some administrative jobs as freelancer or just the project that I have started in the business plan. No, it is a good question. If it's a normal freelancer, okay, because remember that we have two kind of permits, entrepreneurship and freelancer, okay? Freelancer is more open. So really, if you then have to change activity or do several activities, there is no going to be a problem. But take into consideration that when you are a freelance, you have to enroll in the tax office and say the activity that you are doing. So if you are changing activity, remember to change or declare the additional activity, which it doesn't have any more expensive, but is the correct way to do it is to declare and invoice the activity that you are really doing. Then for a renewal, it's not going to be a problem. We can, if you have a really work, there is not going to be a problem. We will say, okay, my business changed, the market changed, and I found this, and I did this, and I make a living of this, and it's going to be perfect. Yes. Juan Carlos, any addition?
Yeah, actually, what they care the most is that you have the money to renew. So if they say that your business is good, and that you have been paying your taxes, that you're okay with Social Security, and that you have enough money to live by yourself, then you're going to get renewed, even if you change activity. And of course, you can do any kind of freelance job as long as you report it to the administrative authorities.
Okay.
So shall I read one from our list that was previously sent?
Okay.
Because we have one from Bilal Javed.
Okay.
It's asking, it's been 1 month since I have submitted documents after completing 3 years in Spain on the basis of arraigo social. But right now, my flat owner told me that he's going to give baja of empadronamiento from his flat. I am searching new house for my empadronamiento. Will this baja affect me because my documents are on the process?
Well, it is important that you are in the empadronamiento. So really, if there is going to be a baja, you can enroll in another place. So submit this new document, because it's true that maybe they can check, and if they see, because the thing is that he submitted a month ago, right, Juan Carlos?
Yes, just a month ago.
So if they check it and you are not enrolled in any place, it can be a problem, because it's mandatory to do the arraigo wherever you are empadronado. So it can be some trouble. I recommend you to, if you are the baja, enroll in another place. You don't have to lease a place. Someone can allow you to empadronarse in their place, a friend, a family, whoever is it. You don't need to rent the place. And now we can do empadronamientos online, that we are saying. We can do everything online right now, more or less everything. It is it is a good thing about the COVID, and empadronamiento is one of those. So really change the address and submit the new address. It is normal to change addresses, but what I don't think is very good is to be the baja in an empadronamiento and not be the alta in another place.
Yes, and also very important to submit that to the foreigners office, because
exactly,
the communications you're going to receive, maybe you will receive requirements, you're going to have any notification from the foreigners office, and if you don't read it in time, you will not be able to comply with the requirements and your application may be archived or rejected. So yes, just be sure to communicate these circumstances to the foreigners office as soon as you have a new place.
Exactly. And one thing about the arraigos, you remember that arraigos are also a procedure that now we can submit online, and we've seen a lot of arraigos also that because of this COVID, they are losing like the job offer. If your company tells you that they don't want to continue with the arraigo, that they will not enroll you in Social Security, if the arraigo is approved, it is the right moment before resolving, before immigration resolving the arraigo, to change employer and submit the new documents for the new employer, okay? Because there's been a lot of cases like that, and immigration has clarified that if you submit a new employer before the resolution, they are going to take into account the new documents of the new company. So don't get stuck. Just if this is happening, go quick and look for another company and submit inside of your procedure, submit the new documents of this new company with a new contract with this company, of course. Okay, Maria. Nielsen says, do years on a student visa count towards the residency requirement to be a citizen? Muchas gracias. No. Juan Carlos, do you want to explain it?
Yes, I'm sorry, Nielsen, but student visa is not considered a residence, so it will not count towards nationality. However, it will count towards long permit residence, like the one that we were talking about before.
Exactly.
So, it will not count for towards nationality, but just to the other kind of permits. And from that permit, it will count towards nationality. So maybe you might want to change to a permit so you can start to count towards nationality.
And remember, a larga duración is not that different to the passport. So of course it's different, but it gives you the right to come back to Spain for your whole life, which is something very important, and to have a work permit for your whole life. So a larga duración, Unión Europea, I think is something that you need to look for before nationality if you are not able to apply for nationality, because the law that applies you is 10 years. That normally you know that for all the foreigners are 10 years, but it is true for Latin Americans and one for every foreigner married to a Spanish citizen. But if you already have the larga duración, it's going to make your life much easier. You don't need to be working in order to renew. And as I told you, you can come back to Spain even if you leave Spain for 10 years and you want to come back. Okay, more questions. Let's read. Amelia. To extend a student visa, what kind of documents count as proof of financial means? Does a bank statement from bank account in home country count? Juan Carlos, we do a lot. So.
Yes, it counts as long as you have the funds available for you. If you can get that money as soon as you want, yes, it counts. Well, it doesn't count as like the investment, but you can use the money that you have on your own country. Okay, so the only thing that they have not liking so much in the foreigners offices is that you show just online bank statements.
Exactly.
So like a bank certificate, you should talk to your bank executive in the States or whatever country you are and ask them for a bank certificate, preferably if it has a signature or a stamp of the bank, that would be much better. And of course, it will have to be translated. We understand that those are only numbers mostly, but the Spanish authorities will tell you to translate the document. So yes, it's valid, but it should meet certain requirements.
Exactly. Remember, apostille is not needed, okay? Because you sometimes there is some confusion, but translation, it is needed. And what is a bank certificate? More or less is a letter with a stamp and a signature of the bank. I know you are very used to print from the from the bank statements from internet, but this is not something that they really like. So try to have this letter because you will not have any problem, even if it's from the US. Okay, more questions. Let me read one of these. Jacob said, I am an auxiliar de conversación here in Madrid and have been on Facebook in various threads, questions about TIE, and it's been extended by the amount of time we have been in the state of alarm. It is true? Yes. So for everyone that the NIE is expiring, it is not really expiring. Even if you have reached the date, from March 14th, the days are not counting. So what you need to know is if that your NIE is expiring now, really you will have like 1 month and a half now, nearly 2 months, but 1 month and a half more than the expiration. So if you want to go to an appointment to renew or to go to the registro to submit it yourself, even if you are counting that maybe you are over time, you are not over time because times are on hold. But we are recommending if you can, doing it electronically. So with your digital certificate, if you have, or with a lawyer if you want, because they are resolving very, very quick. And the problem about waiting because you have more time, it is on hold. It is not expiring, but the problem about this is that there is going to be so many people having to do it, going to registro or to an appointment whenever they can, that you are going to be waiting very, very long. And when you are waiting very long for the renewal, afterwards, there are problems with the resolution that it takes longer. There are problems with the autorización de regreso. So if you can, do it on time. But it's true that times are on hold. He continues saying, for example, he's clarifying. In that case, would a regreso be required for leaving and returning before August? Or if you are able to answer this question, okay. Yes, what I recommend is doing it on time, even that you are able to do it, doing it on time. And in this case, it will be even easier to get an autorización de regreso because remember that for an autorización de regreso, you need to show that you already have applied for the renewal. So today, you even can't apply for an autorización de regreso because policy is closed. But whenever the estado de alarma finishes, normally you should be able to go. And the autorización de regreso will only be issued if you have renew. So go ahead and renew it. That is our recommendation. Okay. Something to add, Juan Carlos?
I think that's nothing to add. That's just what we recommend. Yes.
Yes, that is what we are recommending. You can do it with your digital certificate if you don't want to use a lawyer, but do it. Do it now. You can see our resolutions are in a week, in 4 days, in 2 weeks. So it's worth it, I think, to have it already and forget about days and expirations. True. Okay, Maria, more questions. Heather say, hello. Can I use my student visa so that my partner from Chile can obtain a resident permit and work permit? Thank you. Well, not really, because I'm going to clarify the several things. One, a student can have a family member, okay? So there is a visa for a family member of a student. Only with partner, it is a little more difficult because we need to really show very well that you are a couple, but it is possible. But I think that if he is from Chile, it is better to apply for cuenta ajena, because from Chile and from Peru, people have like a special agreement in which they can, if they have a job offer, they can have the residency and work permit directly. So not really now, because now that permit is on hold because of the COVID, but once this COVID ends, so in 3 weeks, this procedure will be available. So it's much better, I think, that you find for him any kind of job with minimum salary, any kind, okay? And he can get the work permit for a year and then he will renew it from here. That is my recommendation.
Yes.
Okay. Juan Carlos, the next question from Sarah. Do you read it?
Yes, sure. This is Sarah Kay, and she is asking, I'm an auxiliary in Madrid. We have a lot of auxiliaries, actually, in our office, who is looking to renew my NIE TIE, but was wondering if it's also possible for you to help me with a regreso at this time so I can visit my family in the US this summer.
Okay, make a little summary of what I said, right? Because it is good, yes, to clarify it. An alternative, because if she really wants to go and he hasn't get the autorización de regreso, we always recommend.
Yes, sure, because at the moment it's not possible to get an autorización de regreso. However, you are able to renew your application online as soon as possible. And even if you travel, as there is no autorización de regreso available because police officers are closed, that doesn't mean that you're not able to come back, because they cannot ask you for the impossible. If you weren't able to do the autorización de regreso because they weren't allowing it, then you can go with the receipt, and then when you want to re-enter, you can show that this is still in permit, on study on, or we can make a letter to explain your circumstances, because remember, the person that is going to allow you to enter Spain is going to be first a member of the flight company and then the police officer in the immigration border, in the border. So you have to explain it. However, we have had students and they are allowed to enter Spain even with the borders closed, because they are considered to be residents in Spain. Residents, we say like that. But you shouldn't worry. However, this is for summer. So remember that the circumstances are changing month by month. So maybe you should have this question later, but if this was going to be done today, there is no autorization de regreso. Just renew your NIE as soon as possible, and with that receipt, you may travel. However, we advise you to get a package of documents that will allow you to explain to a police officer and to a flight company officer that you are a resident in Spain and that you went there to visit a familiar or whatever, and that you want to come back to Spain because you live in Spain.
In any case, worst case scenario, okay, because we always recommend what Juan Carlos is saying, and worst case scenario, there is a visa that we can apply at the consulate in order to enter if you have lost your NIE, if it has expired and you don't have the autorización de regreso. So 90% of the time, because for example Madrid has a lot of is very busy in Christmas, and even there are no appointments for autorización de regreso, we recommend to come back with like a package of the renewal done, the approval or whatever. But worst case scenario, with a special visa at the consulate, will let you enter. But I don't think it will be needed, but there is that possibility. Okay, Maria, more questions. Okay, can I renew my non-lucrative visa even if my passport is valid only for 11 more months? Yes, good question. Because it's true that they are more restrictive with the first visas, that sometimes normally they want 6 months of validity, but sometimes they will also 1 year of validity. But that is for the first application. For renewals, they are not going to put any trouble, okay? You can renew it perfectly with 11 months for the expiration. No problem at all. From the list. Okay. Amir says, hello. What reason makes the police deport immigrants? Can immigrants be deported just for overstay, even if the immigrant has zero crime, friendly kind? And do they have any rights? Well, yes, they can even deport you because you were not legal in Spain. That is why you have to become legal. And Spain is a place where there are several ways to get legal. So when they want to deport someone, it is a long procedure, okay? They start the process, you can do the allegations, and then they do a resolution. In the resolution, of course, if there are crimes, it is worse, much worse, but they're going to make, they're going to take into consideration more things like your links to Spain. So how long have you been here? The longer, the better, because you've been more, you are more linked to Spain. If you have family, it's better. If you have a job offer, it is better. Even if you don't have a permit, but saying that you are waiting for the 3 years to apply for the work permit, and you already have an employer. So they are going to analyze all the links to Spain, which is family, time, job, money, and of course, if you don't have crime, it's better. But just to be illegal, they can tell you that you have to leave. Okay, and the bad thing about that also is that they put a prohibition, a ban to enter in Spain normally for 3 years. So well. Our recommendation to try to be legal always if that you can, because I know a lot of even US citizens that they keep going back and forward because they don't really find that they have found that they have needed this permit, but then things like this happen and they cannot enter anymore because only residents can come. And I know that they don't check as much to American than to other countries. But our recommendation is to become legal whenever you can. And even if you are not have like a package ready in your home with evidences of your links to Spain, because if they stop you and they start a procedure, at least you will have a lot of things ready so you can send them to the lawyers and we can present to the police a good case. Because if you are now stopped by the police there in a CIE, that is called CIE, and we need to get evidence and you are not able to prepare it, it is more difficult. And of course, do the empadronamiento also is a good evidence also. Okay.
Yes.
Something to add, Juan Carlos?
Yes, I should add just like some people, just to know, you don't have to get in trouble to get deported. We have a lot of people that have been living in here without getting in trouble. And sometimes because they lock into a hotel, because they go to travel by train, because they travel by plane. Remember that there are a lot of places that are linked to the police station and they have these alerts on it. So if they detect on that alert that you are overstaying in Spain, they will come and visit you and you may face a procedure. So try to get an empadronamiento as soon as possible. Of course, you have rights. You cannot be deported immediately, but and you can appeal the decision of being deported, but they can do it even if you don't get in trouble and you have no criminal record, just to add that.
Exactly. Thank you, Juan Carlos. Okay, Jen says, hello, I'm looking to do my pareja estable with you soon and was told by my student program I can still apply to renew my student visa and do the stable at the same time. Is this true? Yes, and it's recommendable. So I always recommend, it's true that if you are going to do a pareja estable and you will apply for family member of a European Union, even if you become irregular, even if you become illegal, you will be able to apply. But of course, it's better not to get irregular. So we also recommend you, as your school told you, to renew your student visa while you are doing the pareja estable, and whenever it is granted, the familiar de comunitario permit, you will switch it. But of course, it is much better if you are continue studying to renew your student visa and switch whenever the other one is granted.
Yes, and actually, this is the best time to apply for this kind of permits, because one thing that is an advantage right now is that you don't have to wait for an appointment. You can do it online with a digital certificate or through a lawyer. And actually, we have very good news about it, because last week we had three resolutions for pareja estable approved by a family member of a citizen of the European Union in just a couple of days. Some of them a week, tops 1 month, but they are issuing resolutions really fast. And right now, you don't have to wait for an appointment. Remember that before the state of alarm, waiting for an appointment could be really extremely hard procedure. We have to wait even for 3 or 4 months just to get the appointment.
Yes.
Some of the documents expire, you have to get the documents again. Right now, while the state of alarm is still on force, we are going to be able to submit your applications without having to wait for an appointment, and you may not be able to have to wait for the 3 months. Maybe you will get a resolution much faster.
Exactly. Our recommendation, if you can do the submission now remotely, really is much better. Look our publications in, they are, I always complaining, and I'm incredibly satisfied with immigration. So go ahead and do the application. And if you want to do it with us, send it to us. We will prepare it, because it is very, very good. Let's see from the list. Bernard, how much unemployment benefits should I receive under the ERTE? I've been unemployed more than 1 year. Thanks. Juan Carlos, labor law. Okay. Who is your...
one of the most asked questions that we have. Okay. If you are an ERTE, you are going to receive 70% of your base salary, okay? Just to give you an example, if your base salary on the payroll states that you have 1,000 euros of base salary, then that means that you are going to get 700 euros. This is for the first 6 months. After the first 6 months, you're going to get 50%. But there are another kind of quantities. For example, if you have a children, you may get more money. You can get up to 1,400, and if you don't have children, you will get as much as 1,100 euros. It depends a lot if you have children or not, and it depends a lot on your salary. But right now, the top amount, even if you earn 5,000 euros per month, if you are an ERTE, you are only going to get 1,400 euros having children, and 1,100 euros if you don't have any children. This is the 70% of the base salary that appears on your payroll.
Yes, so check your payroll and it says salario base, and from there you get the 70%. Remember, for the renewal, it's okay. You don't have any trouble, because it's like you were working. Good luck with this, with that ERTE. I hope it finishes quick. Okay, Reveses, my second temporary residency cuenta propia renewal got approved in March. Congratulations. However, I'm now also eligible to apply for the European Union long residency. Can I apply for it now? Yes, before getting my new TA. Yes. Do it now. You don't need the plastic. You will not even have it, I think, because if they resolve it quick, that they will give you directly the new NIE of long term European Union. So remember, for this one, the 5 years, I hope you've done the calculation good. The times of the residency plus 50% of the student, and the main thing is to show a stable economic means, that If you have done the second renewal of the cuenta propia, is because you are working good and stable and you will be fine. And that was our recommendation when we started this streaming. So yes, you can do it without doing fingerprints for this new resolution. Just in the application, if you are going to do it yourself, show that it was approved, okay? The letter that was approved. Or if you don't have the letter, even the screenshot, and whenever, because they have the information, but whenever you get the resolution, submit it and put it together with the application. Okay.
Yeah, we must insist, apply for a long-term permit. This is going to be a lifesaver after all the situation. Just apply as long as possible as you can. We are getting resolutions of this kind of permits before the 45 days that the law states. We had the last one, it was in 30 days, maybe a little less. So go ahead and apply as soon as you get the 5 years, or if you meet the requirements, given that you were a student before.
Exactly. Samson says, a friend finished his PhD here in Spain and later obtained the búsqueda de empleo to enable him search a job here. Please, can he modify his residency to cuenta ajena or cuenta propia? Yes. So remember, when you have a búsqueda de empleo, okay, they give you a year in order to build your own business or look for a job. But they give you a year, but whenever you are able to get a job, even if it's after 1 month of having the búsqueda de empleo, you can. So depending on what kind of job you will get, you apply for one residency or other. So if it's a very good job, you can apply for high qualified worker visa if you want. It is a normal job for contrato de prácticas with a contrato de prácticas. If you have reached the whole year, so if really this is not at the beginning, is at the end of the year, then yes, you can switch to cuenta ajena, okay? But only after all the year of búsqueda de empleo, tu cuenta ajena o tu cuenta propia, as you are asking. So if you find something before the year, is prácticas or high qualified worker, and whenever you reach the year, you can continue as you are with high qualified worker or practicas or change to cuenta ajena. If you have spent all your year of búsqueda de empleo, you change to cuenta ajena o cuenta propia if you have your own business, of course. But even if it's your own business and you have it 1 month after the búsqueda de empleo, you can apply for cuenta propia after a month of búsqueda de empleo.
Yeah, and also he has a PhD, so maybe he may be able to get a researcher permit. This is something that a lot of universities and investigation centers are hiring right now. We have a lot of
we do a lot, yes.
Yes, and you can start to work with the universities to give your curriculum, and you may be able to get a researcher permit. And this is a permit that, as a high qualified worker, gets an approval within 20 working days. So yes, just take the advantage of being a PhD.
Exactly, exactly. Even studying a PhD, remember, there is the special permit, not getting the student one. If you are accepted in a PhD, you can already get the researcher one. So a lot of people don't know this, and as for the student visa, it is much better the researcher one. So all the researchers that are here and all the PhD, verify what kind of permit you have and change to the researcher one, because it's a residency, it includes the family, it is include a work permit, so it's much, much better than the student one. Okay, let's get one of the list. Tilna says, do we need to change to búsqueda de empleo first from a student visa to apply to work permit? With búsqueda, can we apply for practicas other work permit based on the new law? Last question. It is true that we should wait until the búsqueda expires before we can apply for the work permit. What if we get a job sooner? Okay, Tina, Tina, this is what I was explaining just before, because a lot of people think this. No. Whenever you find the job, you switch to practicas, okay? Even if you have already only have been a month of búsqueda de empleo, you switch to practicas. As soon as you get a job, you change. If you have the work offer already when you finish, you don't need to apply for búsqueda de empleo. You can apply for practicas directly, okay? Búsqueda de empleo is because you don't have a job yet, so we do búsqueda de empleo, and whenever you have the job offer, we switch to practicas. If you are finishing your studies, even while you are studying, even if you haven't finished and you have an offer, we can do the residencia por practicas, because they remember that the law says that you need to have finished or been enrolled in a degree or in a master's degree. So whenever you have a job offer, you can switch to practicas. And if you don't have it, you switch to búsqueda de empleo when you finish. And as soon as you get a job offer, you switch again to practicas. María, Daniel says, hello, I'm an auxiliar de conversación. I'm trying to renew online via clave, but it's saying acceso restringido. Who should I call or what should I do? Juan Carlos.
Yeah, this is a very common technical issue. And you can do it by verifying that you meet the requirements. Okay, you should go to a website that will say, verify that you meet all the requirements for clave. And sometimes this is an issue for people that don't have Java installed on their computer. Okay, so just try to install Java on the computer. Don't use Google Chrome, don't use Mac, use Internet Explorer, and then try to do it installing Java and do it from there. If not, contact us, because we have had this problem before with other people, even other lawyers, and we were able to solve it. So try to do it like that, and if not, please contact us and we will be able to help you, sure.
Yes, because it's going to be same fees as an IT, that because it's an IT problem, but we are used to fix it.
Yes, we have it a lot.
Okay, let's get one from the list. Juan Carlos, do you read it?
Yes, this is Emily Keating. Is it possible to apply for Pareja de Hecho right now? Can we begin the process or do we have to wait? However, this is from Seville, so.
Okay, well, we can double check from Seville and publish it, but I would like to tell you. More or less, all the procedures are becoming more and more telematic. We can check if in Seville they are receiving documents remotely. And also, remind you that even that you cannot do it, maybe we can do a familiar de comunitario with pareja estable. So remember, to have family member or familiar de comunitario, we have three ways. Marriage, pareja de hecho, pareja estable. Sometimes we start doing pareja estable, that is proving the relationship before having the pareja de hecho, or while it is a processing, because it takes long. So maybe something interesting for you, check if you have evidences regarding your convivencia, so living together. Not only empadronamiento together, okay? They are going to check for more evidences about the relationship, bank accounts together, trip together. If you have, I always say, the life insurance that you even don't know that you have it, but when you open a bank account, they always sell you this kind of life insurance, so it put as benefit the other person. And well, you can even have the familiar de comunitario as pareja estable, even that you don't have the pareja de hecho in Seville. But in any case, tomorrow we will verify it and we will post how it's working in Seville, okay? Because for us it's also interesting for more clients.
Sure.
Okay, Ayan says, I'm renewing the tarjeta comunitaria, I have submitted accreditation de la permanencia continuada. What do they accept as proof for this? My card expires June 29th. When is the latest I can renew? Okay, well, this is a familiar permanente. So the main thing and the more useful thing is to ask for the certificado de pareja de hecho, a new certificado de pareja de hecho that says that you still be pareja de hecho or marriage, because does it say that what kind of link she has or not? No.
I think she doesn't.
Okay, well, if it's pareja de hecho, ask for a new certificate with this actual date, so they see that you have continued living together with the empadronamiento together, and that will be fine. If you haven't got a pareja de hecho and it's pareja estable, it's more evidence again. It's like the first time. You need to show that you continue having everything together, like bank accounts, that the insurance, the rent agreement, trips together. But if it's through marriage or through pareja de hecho, getting an actual certificate will be the proof that they really want, in addition to the economic means again, in addition to to the ID of the European citizen and all the documents. And regarding when, from all the others, from 2 months before to 3 after. And of course, you remember that we can do it telematic, remotely. When is it says? It was June, right? I think
29th of June, I think, yes.
And now we are in May, so she can already do it if you want. And the pareja de hecho can issue now normally. We can see if they can issue the certificate, but with it's not like doing a new pareja de hecho, so this is working remotely. That for sure they can give it to you now. Okay. Babette says, hi, my company is submitting an autorización para trabajo inicial 8 months ago and I just received an UGE estimar decision in the beginning of April. High qualified worker visa. What is strange? Now because of COVID, it's very, very strange that, but well, now because of COVID, my employer no longer wants to give me the contract, even so that is the only thing I need to get my residency card now. Oof, what can I do in my situation? For context, I am American and in March 20, I had a residency permit in Germany. The job is for an orchestra in Madrid. Wow. Yeah. Really?
This is a really tough situation.
Yes, because really you need the alta to be valid, your high qualified worker visa, you need to work for that company that did the procedure. Of course, this is a special circumstance, and if you find a new company, of course they will be able to proceed a new one, and it will be quick, because I don't know why they took 8 months. I don't know if they did something wrong and it was like stuck because they put it on hold, but you need to check your possibilities. Maybe in Germany you can ask what we were saying, but the other way around. Maybe in Germany you can ask for the larga duración en Unión Europea and then ask for here a permit, or of course if you find a new employer. So maybe when you need, if you want to do a consultation with us and we find all the ways that we can solve this, because really, high qualified workers as practicas are linked to the employer. So if you don't have that employer anymore, it's a problem and we need to find another solution. Sorry for that. What a bad luck.
Yeah.
Okay, Mike. Hi, my wife have a job in Sitges starting in September, so we will be moving there in August. I have a limited company in the UK and I will be working remotely from Sitges. What documents do I need to get an EM? My wife will need her offer of employment I would imagine. Okay, but we have to see how your wife is coming, because maybe it's coming with a high qualified worker visa, and high qualified worker visa includes family, so you will come with that. If she comes with a normal cuenta ajena, it cannot. I don't know what is the work about, because if it's not a what is called permiso de residencia con exceptuación a trabajo, for example, for teachers, there are other. It is difficult to get a normal employee permit if it's not high qualified worker visa and if not practicas, huh? It is. I think it must be high qualified worker visa, so you come with her. If not, you can come with a non-lucrative. But we really need to see what is the kind of permit that she gets to see if you are included. If not, maybe non-lucrative will be the best solution for you.
Yeah, and if you don't want to wait for a non-lucrative to be issued at the consulate, given the circumstance right now, if he doesn't need a visa to come here, maybe he can come here as a tourist, get into a student course, be a student. Maybe he wants to study from here. Because if he's going to be working remotely for a company in the UK, he doesn't need to apply for a job permit, because that doesn't need you to have a job permit.
Very good idea, Juan Carlos. Yes, so now consulates are going to be stuck a little. I think they are going to take longer than usual to issue the visas because they were not working for 2 months. So if this is not very interesting for you to wait for the consulate, and some consulates are worse than others, we know that, it is a good idea. You can come study, for example, a Spanish course, and you can be here with your wife, and really, as Juan Carlos is telling you, you will be fine working for your own company remotely. So very good idea, Juan Carlos. You can choose whatever is better for you. Okay, Maria. Okay, Andrea says, hi, thanks you for this live streaming. Thank you to watch. My question is, I got a master's here in Spain back in 2018. I'm currently on a búsqueda de empleo permit and I have a job offer. Congratulations. My employer tried to get the autorización de trabajo por cuenta ajena and wasn't possible because of the situación nacional de empleo. Will I be able to get permiso de prácticas? Yes, that is the right one. Or get an autorización de trabajo por cuenta propia to work with them as an autónomo? No. If your employer did a cuenta ajena, it's because he's willing to have it as an employee. And really, if you didn't reach the 1 year of búsqueda de empleo, the right one to apply is prácticas. So that is why it was denied. So apply for prácticas. It needs to be approved in a month, and you will be you will be able to start working. And then once you reach the year from the moment that you apply for búsqueda de empleo, if you then want to switch to cuenta ajena, because it's better for you, because you can switch jobs, or even if you lose the job at some point, you can switch jobs and you will be able to renew, even working only 6 months per year, do it, because now we can do it everything remotely. So first practicas, okay? And we can do it remotely and you will be working in a month. And whenever we reach a year, modify to cuenta ajena if you want, because it's better for you. The good thing now is that we can do it remotely, which is much better and much quicker. I don't know if when you reach the year this will be available. I hope so. I hope they continue with everything remotely. And that's a little mistake that your employer did. If he want to contact us, we can guide him.
Yeah, but if the employer is willing to hire her, that's the best thing.
The best thing to do is to have practicas, not freelancer. Freelancers takes very long and is worse for you. Yeah, sure. It's just that he chose the wrong permit to be approved. Okay, Maria. So Kirsten says, since I wasn't able to get my new TA card from 2019 renewal, fingerprints upon me, Will I have an issue while my renewal? No, you don't. I receive my resultado favorable, but don't know the expiration date is on my thesis. I wasn't issued a new one. Yes, that is true. You don't know it. Maybe you can ask for them. You can ask if they can tell you what is the expiration, but normally, you know, I don't know if it's a work permit or a student permit. You know that normally a student permit is for the course. A work permit, the first is for 1 year, the second for 2 years, the second renewal also for 2 years, and then larga duración. So you can do your calculations, and whenever you are not going to have any problem, and whenever you do the fingerprints in 2 months, whenever they put the appointments, you will really check the expiration. Okay, we are getting to the hour. Maria, choose the five last if there are. We have here one. What are the benefits of larga duración and the difference, I think, no? Or benefits of larga duración and citizenship? Any difference or benefits on these two status? Okay. So larga duración is not passport, it's not a Spanish passport. You don't become a European Union citizen. So, and even they can even take you out the larga duración because of criminal records, for example, and any other bad circumstances, like being a dangerous person for the Spanish interest or whatever, but really, and for any subsidies, maybe for Europeans, you cannot apply any positions, like a lot of civil servants or funcionarios, you need to be Spanish and it's not valid the larga duración. So these are the kind of differences, but really in the practice areas of having rights regarding being here, it is very good, the larga duración. It is not passport, but really allows you to come back to Spain or to Europe whenever you want, even if you've been 10 years out, allows you to work whenever you can, allows you to reunificate your family if you need it. Juan Carlos, any other difference or any other benefit?
Yeah, well, if you are Spanish, then you will be able to vote. So you will be able to complain about the politicians here, and you will be able to be on siesta whenever you want legally. So, but yes, be able to vote. And I think that the most important part, the most interesting part of being a Spanish national is, of course, that you will be able to apply for job positions as a civilian officer. And for example, right now, some of the medics they weren't able to be hired by some of hospitals, because they were only for persons that were Spanish nationals, okay? So it's something to consider just in case, from positions.
Okay, Maria, Kevin Whittaker says, how is the 50% time on a student visa calculated? For example, if my permit was officially from October 2018 to July 2019, does that count as a full year or only 9 months? Only 9 months. And then if it's 9 months, it will count as 4.5 months towards the larga duración. If you have doubts, we can apply for what is called certificado de residencia, that it should tell you, but sometimes it doesn't show, but it should tell you everything. It should tell you from how long to how long you were a student, for how long to how long you were a resident, so you can calculate correctly. When we have people that have doubts, we always apply for that, for certificado de residencia, to calculate all the dates. Okay, Maria, Amelia says, can you extend a student visa if you are changing student programs, master program to auxiliar de conversación? Yes, this is a very good question. Before, there were a lot of denials in the prórroga de estudios because you were changing studies, okay? But now, because you can study, you can apply for also for a new student visa from here, really it doesn't make a difference, because if they don't think it is a renewal, because they think you are not following the same path of studies, they will treat it as a new student visa. And because you can also do it from here and the requirements are the same, it will not make the difference. But make sure that if you are changing, just in case, do it before the expiration, because 30 days before the expiration, because when you do an application, a new visa application for a student visa from here, they tell you to have 30 days left to be available to do it. So if they are understanding this as a new student visa and not as a prórroga, they could deny it if you are doing it after the expiration. So my recommendation when you are changing studies, just in case, doing it 2 months before, that you know that you can do the renewal 2 months before, do it, because this case, even if they understand it as a new student visa, you will not have any problem. Maria, are there any more, or we are done? I think we are done.
One from the list, I know.
Okay.
From Diana, I think she's asking if my permit for cuenta ajena was approved, but the company has closed due to the virus, and they did not get to register me as a worker. Can I work for another company?
Is cuenta ajena?
Yes, this is a cuenta ajena. I mean.
No, that is a problem. It's really a problem, and it is something that maybe we can really negotiate with immigration, because really they have to find some special solutions for this time. For sure, we have to check if it's a cuenta ajena, modificación to cuenta ajena. If it's a cuenta ajena, the company has to really do the enrollment. But in this case, maybe they allow you to show a new company with all the documents of the new company, and allows you to, whenever they find that is correct, the new company to enroll you. So this is like a special appeal saying what happens to you, but you will need to get a new company for the enrollment. Okay, good luck, and sorry for that. We are hearing a lot of cases like that also in Arraigos. That is why we are telling you that if you are in the procedure, not with the resolution yet, they are allowing to change. But now if you are in the resolution, we need to do like an special appeal to really try to get the approval, but with a new company. Good luck with that. We did an appeal to the court like 4 years ago regarding this, and I hope that now immigration don't make us go to the court and give solutions to this without going to the court. But it's a problem that is going to happen more and more. Sorry for that. Juan Carlos, I think we are done again. 1 hour, yes. 10 minutes answering questions. For me, I'm really enjoying these live streams, because we see what is happening. We are trying to help you, and we also are actualized of what are the doubts of the people, and we feel closer to you. I hope this is helping you. We try to fix all what we can and to give you good news. It's true that we don't have all the solutions like this, that when you lose the employer that has to enroll you, it is difficult. But in any case, don't leave it that way. We need to try to solve it. We need to try to find another company. You are close to have your residency. Yeah, are the last efforts. I know it's complicated, but in the end, it will be just be a good story to tell to your granddaughters. Juan Carlos, thank you for being here.
Thank you all for being here too, to listen to us. And remember, 50% of all our consultations by Skype, by telephone, by email. And right now we have that offer, so take advantage of it. We are here for you.
Exactly. Remember, tomorrow we have live with one of our clients. She's very, very nice. You will enjoy it a lot. She did it arraigo by herself, and I did larga duración for her, larga duración Unión Europea. So I think it's very interesting. She is very nice. You will enjoy it. I when I knew her like years ago in an Spain Guru meetup, I was like laughing every time she was telling her story, because she really knows how to tell her story. So it is a good way to review larga duración en Europea, but also arraigos, that you all have a lot of confusion between arraigo and modification and all that. And we will be answering more questions if you have more. So thank you for being here. Thank you, Juan Carlos, Maria, Raquel, and everyone who was from the law firm helping us, and of course, to all of you that you are watching us, and we see you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye.